Well, Regina Hill told me she knew the moment she threw her hat in this race, her past will surface. She says her long drug and DUI offenses makes her qualified to represent District 5. Hill is campaigning hard and not worried about what others are saying about her long rap sheet.
We have a large amount of felons in this community, and when they see me, they see hope.
It's coming out, man. Support me.
48-year-old Regina Hill stands strong and confident despite her criminal history. It dates as far back as 1989 when she was charged with possession of cocaine with intent to sell.
See, my skeletons are out the closet. I don't have any.
She's had half a dozen DUI arrests. Some were dismissed. A number of drug offenses, too. The last time she was arrested was in 2009 for contempt of court.
I don't think that's going to hurt my campaign. I think I'm the person qualified because I've came from this community. I lived a life that over 60% in this community have lived. I've walked in their shoes.
State records show Hill had her civil rights restored in 2008 by the Florida Parole Commission's office. That gave her a second chance in life and a chance to run for public office to represent District 5 in the Orlando City Council.
It's not about a title. I'm going to City Hall to be a servant of the people.
Hill says she's involved in multiple nonprofit organizations that help convicts, the poor, and the homeless. In fact, this ex-felon says she helped him get his life back together.
I go to college now. I go to Valencia. So I tell other people now, you know, through her helping and letting us know that we can do this and we can do that. So she's been a big help.
Despite her past, Hill says she's clean, redeemed, and ready to serve the people.
So you can criticize me all you want, but I'm on a mission and I won't quit. And my mission is not to get to City Hall. My mission is to become better because of my past and to empower others because of it.
There are two other candidates running for District 5, incumbent Daisy Lynam and Cynthia Harris. Election day is a Tuesday, April 8th. Reporting live in the Satellite Center, Jack Yodosko, Fox 35 News.